Today I'll be taking you on my second thrifting haul. I began over at the jewelry cases, and as you can see, there was an array of jewelry, earrings, necklaces, watches, some brooches. There were some really nice brooches there. There were a couple of pieces that I was interested in, so I was more interested in looking at some of the other pieces and didn't get back to it. But at some point I will go back and take a look at those brooches if they're still there. But there were a lot of beautiful pieces there. Some of the pieces were a bit overpriced, so I just moved on and thought I would just get back to that later. Then I went over to the home decor, and as you can see, there was lots of pictures there. There's a picture of Audrey Hepburn, and of course I purchased that piece, and one of the Eiffel Tower. And the piece that was just above Audrey was of a hunting scene. So there was just a nice selection of pictures. And then I moved over to some of the bedding and passed that up. And then I saw the school desk here. And of course, we know the kids are going back to school here in another few days, weeks. So that was kind of neat. And of course, I went back and I was looking for that pillow that I passed up. And did not see it, but there were a nice array of pillows that were stacked up. Then I ran across this adorable cat pillow, and that was pretty nice. And over to the next shelf, there were more pillows. And then it was on to the toys, and again, there were lots of those. And of course, there were also bagged on the wall. And a great cabinet there, and this great table, and I think that was a bureau there. And then it was on to the electronics department, and a great bench there, and that was painted pink, and another dining room set. And there's a dresser and another table. And this time around, there was lots and lots of furniture. So, I don't know if it maybe it was from a furniture store or a liquidation of some sort, but there was lots of that, and lots of lamps, and so there was some really nice selections there. And of course, I fell in love with this vase, and when I took it to the front counter, there was no price on it, but I took it to the front counter, and the lady said that they would price it for me the next day, so eventually I'll be going back to get that. And then I saw this great swivel lamp, and I thought that would be ideal for my sewing and sitting room. And so that was pretty nice. And then you had some ceiling fans here, and there were some mattresses. And there's a great chair. In fact, there's two great chairs there. And this one really caught my eye. And the camera will go back. This chair right here really caught my eye. So that was an adorable chair there. And a great bureau there. And that would be nice if you had a plasma TV and the drawers had plenty of space where you can put an array of things that you have, your remote, if you have any kind of cassettes or videos or DVDs, that kind of thing. That would be a great place to store that. And that's a great little bookshelf there. And there's an end table there. Then there was this great little pantry here. You could put some shelves there and for some of the things in your kitchen, and also they could be used for the bathroom. And here's another bureau, and this would be more like a china cabinet here, and that was quite nice. And here's another bureau. So there were lots of beautiful pieces that were brought into the store this time around. And this would be great for a bedroom. And this piece as well. So these are great starter pieces for someone who's getting started with their a new home or an apartment. And I went over and took a look at some of the blouses and dresses. And I didn't buy anything clothing-wise this time around. I just took a look at some of the pieces. Then there was this great little blouse. You could also wear that as a jacket. And many of the other blouses were just as nice, but I passed those up. And then I went over to the other side to look at the dresses. And there's this chevron dress. At least the top portion of the dress was chevron. And the base was black. And then I looked over this beautiful chiffon dress. Could be worn for spring or summer. And has purple and yellow flowers on it and pleating around the bottom. And that was quite nice. And then this dress here was nice as well. And kind of gave you a oriental theme there. And as you can see, there were dresses galore. And then I went over to the book section and I found this Rose Fitzgerald Kennedy book, memoir, and then a chocolate lover's book. And then I went back over to the bookshelf to see what else I could find. And of course, I just love books. And perhaps one day that I will share my book collection with everyone as well. I have a huge bookshelf in my living room. And every time I have people come by, they head over to my bookshelf. So I've had people literally sit on the floor and go through all of my books. So that just is a pleasure to see people just enjoying books, because so many times people are so involved with researching and getting their information offline rather than getting their information through books. So it just brings me lots of joy to see people going through books. And then I also got this great reference cookbook, and I'll be sharing that with you guys in the future. And it's got some great recipes and references on improving one's skills and lots of anecdotes and so forth. Here's the Audrey Hepburn print, fresh from the thrift store, and it's absolutely gorgeous. And I paid $19.99 for the print. And with tax, it came up to $21.66. And you can see all the amazing detailing on it. And the details in her eyes, her lashes, lips, nose, everything. And whoever did this, they did an excellent job. But this is just beautiful. It has like a glass covering on it. And it's just an amazing print. I also measured the print, and it is 19.5 inches across and 38.75 inches down. So that's a pretty substantial print, but I'm so glad that I got it. From my understanding, the cashier at the thrift store told me that there was a Maryland print, and that was snatched up, so I missed it by a day, but I certainly would have gotten that one. But this is just a beautiful piece to add to my home decor. I'm not really sure exactly where the print will go, but I'm looking forward to finding a special spot for it. But this is just amazing. And Audrey was an amazing actress, and as you know, that she was one of her all-time favorite films, which is also mine, is Breakfast at Tiffany's. And I have a original album, I believe it was from 1961, and I reviewed that in a previous video. So if you have not seen the video that I did on my mother's album collection, that was the last album that was reviewed in the video. And as you can see, Lovebug is surveying the portrait. So he gives his doggy approval. You want to say hello to everyone in YouTube land? Are you just going to look at me? Okay. My little love bug. Okay. So
Audrey is officially in my collection, and I am so pleased about this.
Here are the three books that I got from the thrift store. And the first book is Rose Fitzgerald Kennedy, Times to Remember. And this is a memoir. And this book was published in 1974. And the cover is just a little bit worn. Not too bad, but it's in pretty good condition for its age. And on the inside of the book are nice clean pages. And the joint of the book is very nice and tight, and the pages are nice and tight. And I'll show a few pictures of that are in the book. But this first picture on the left is of Joe and Rose in 1914 on their wedding day, and as newlyweds in Poland Springs, Maine in 1915, and Rose as a young mother of her first three children. Rose married Jack and Joe Jr., and that was in 1919. And then here's a photo of Joe and Rose in Palm Beach in 19, I believe that's 1925. And it's just a really good historical book to have. And I'm all about history. I love history. So just to see very personal photos of this iconic family is amazing. And of course, there's a Christmas card here from 1927 showing all the children and the little caricatures there. And then you see the whole family here on the beach. And so this is just a great little reference book. And of course, you know that Miss Kennedy, Mrs. Kennedy, was the mother of John F. Kennedy. And he was our was a president of the United States. So this is a really nice book to have here. And let's see, got a few more here. This is a picture of Miss Rose here on in 1938 when she was presented to court. Excuse me. And this was on in her inaugural dress at the inaugural ball in 1961 for her son John. And so this is a really, really great book, and I'm looking forward to reading it and having it in my library. And the next book is Chocolate Fantasies, and this book I believe was 1986. And let me open it up to be certain. It was 1987. But this is a great book. I'm a chocoholic. And I have one other book on chocolates. And I just thought that this would be kind of nice to have because it has some different recipes in this book. But as you can see, I've got all of my little post-it notes in different on different pages of the book to mark off some of the recipes that I'd like to try. And the first one here is a velvet chocolate cake, and then a sour cream chocolate cake and a chocolate rum cake. So this is a really, really nice book to have too. And there's a chocolate caramel cake, so I'd like to try that as well. But this is a nice little book, and each of these books were $1.49, so I think I spent altogether about $6. Excuse me, for all the books. And this has to be one of the best buys that I got. And this is a New Basics cookbook. And this is a great reference book, as I mentioned earlier. And the nice thing that I like about this book is it's got, especially here in the first chapter, we're coming up on the holiday season, so it gives you a lot of great recipes and little finger foods and things like that that you can make for your guest. And it's got a guacamole recipe. And probably hear some thunder because we've got rain here today. But this is a nice little reference book, and it gives you anecdotes along the way
as
as well. I'm really
well.
looking forward to going through this book and making some of the
Excuse me.
recipes.
Another thing that I liked about the book too is that it had paired wines with your meals. And here's a section here where it pairs your wines with your pastas, and for your game, your meats, your seafoods, all those things. And then you have a vegetable garden lasagna, and I'm looking forward to making that. And the section that I really liked, and I hope I can get to it, and there's a not too sweet potato pie, not too sweet potato pie, excuse me. And the thing that I liked about was the seashore shellfish section. And actually, let me show you the beginning of that section so you can get a better look if I can get back to it. And I'm having to hold the camera with one hand here, but it's a fish market. And it shows you how to buy your fish, and then also there's a section here where it shows you how to pair your wines
Here's
with your
the
fish. Authors on the back. So they did a really great job on putting this book together. Actually, at the time, the book was 1995. So it's a really good book, and I'm glad that I got it. And got it for, I believe this book was actually $2.49 in the chocolate recipe book, and the Rose Kennedy book were $1.49. But those are, I'm really glad that I got these, and I'm looking forward to reading up on Miss Kennedy's life, and using some of the recipes in the other two books.
Thank you for coming along with me on my second thrift haul. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And until next time, wherever you are in the world, be good to yourself and to others.